think I've kissed that many women early in the morning since 1985.
What do you think about that guy we were just talking about?
So he wants to know all the gory details?
Yeah, yeah.
I know.
I don't know, man. I think that's one of those things you ask the question and then you're really sorry you asked.
That's what I was saying. Then you regret it later. Yeah. You want to know, but then you regret it.
Yeah. I know, because once you know it, you can't unknow it.
It's true.
Right. Yeah. And then it works in the back of your brain. Yep. It just starts working.
But he's having erectile dysfunction, the guy.
And that, he thinks that's the cure?
Well, yes, that'll do it, yeah. You know, men are visual.
That was sort of the
We are visual. Article. I'm not going to deny it.
Yeah.
We are.
Yeah.
It's too freaky for me. So I'm so glad to see you because I'm sort of walking.
She's playing Mother Abigail in The Stand, my favorite book ever Stephen King wrote.
Yes.
And I was in the original.
Yes, you were.
Yes, look.
Yes, you were. Oh, wow.
And all of my scenes were with. With your character, and I had Ruby Dee.
Yes, she did.
Ruby Dee played
the great Ruby Dee.
She's great. Was great.
And you're going to be so amazing in this role.
Well, I'm certainly old enough for it now. You're kind of crazy.
What are you supposed to be, 101 or something?
108 or 9 or 10. Yeah.
Who's playing my character, Nick Andros? Do we know?
A kid called Henry Zaga.
Excellent.
Oh, wow.
I can't wait to see it. It's going to be great.
Same. Me too. Yeah. I'm excited. You know, I've been waiting because I was supposed to do it originally when you guys were doing
that.
It. And then I was, I used to be a big old movie star.
You were too young, probably.
I was probably too young, but I also had another job where they said, no, we're not going to let you go and do anything else. And it was like, okay.
I remember Ruby Dee would sleep in her old age makeup. It was such a process.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It was so, it took so long to do
this. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Look 108.
No.
Well, she's so beautiful, and you couldn't do anything to make her look old. She was just so great looking.
You know, in a funny way, that's what happened to me. Anyway.
Do you know how many days I wish the West Wing cast was in the White House right now? I loved you in West
Thank
Wing.
You.
I loved that show so much.
I heard something as I was about to come out here, that there's someone on this panel who has never seen the West Wing. Is this true?
Okay, so this is a thing. There's allegedly a character based on my dad, and it's very political. And as you know, I'm the one that's watching 6 hours of cable news on the weekend because I grew up with cable news on all the time, so I can only take so much politics. But I will watch it if you would like.
I will start watching it tonight.
Okay. But I have seen almost every single episode of Parks and Rec. Does that count?
Well, that's good. That counts. Yeah. I'll take that.
Thank you.
And really, I have to give one more shout out to him. Beyond the Candelabra, hilarious.
Oh, thank you. That might be one of my favorite things I've ever done.
He was so funny as he played a plastic surgeon.
I played a plastic surgeon with a really bad facelift.
For Liberace.
and to be able, when I get to play characters, it's really fun for me.
I want to ask you about your new character.
Yes.
You're still busy. So you have a new project called 911 Lone Star.
Yep. This is Ryan Murphy and I are producing it together.
And it premieres in January.
Yep.
And you start as a complicated New York City firefighter.
That's
then you move to Texas, to Austin. How did you train for this role?
It was great. I love playing real life heroes.
Yeah.
I really do love that. And so I spent a lot of time with the LAFD. Mm-hmm. The city I live in, Santa Barbara, had horrible wildfires a few years ago.
Yeah.
So I actually had a lot of the guys camping and staging at our property. But do you have the clip of me going down the fire pole really slowly?
We just showed it,
By the way, can I tell you, on the show, I'll go down faster. I'm just saying, that's the slowest. Look at how slow that is. That's not good. That's not what you want from your fire.
It's a hard job being a firefighter.
It is hard.
It's hard. Heavy equipment.
Almost like a
really heavy equipment. You have to be in great shape.
Yes.
And the show is going to be fantastic. I've got Liv Tyler joining me on it. We're gonna have a blast.
Well, I'm going to out myself. I haven't seen The West Wing either.
Oh, my gosh,
maybe we can
watch
it together. But I have seen almost everything.
There's a sort of Ainsley Hayes thing going on here.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
But if you need some levity and you need some enjoyment in politics, just binge watch
Brian Tedda, our executive producer, keeps on telling me I've got to watch it, that it's like the best show ever.
Brian's freaking out that you're here.
It'll be a soothing balm.